So, Edie, now that you guys have had the opportunity to kind of dive into Marquette a little bit more, what are you guys seeing, you know, from them, but also how you guys match up against them?
I think their offense is really good. We talked about that. They move it really well. They got some guys that can score the ball, and a guy that the coaches recruited here. It's supposed to be pretty good. Got player of the year. But we're a really good defensive team, and I think, you know, if we can play good offense and play good defense, we should be able to match up with them pretty well.
You mentioned Tyler Cole. Like, he's kind of unique because not only can he score, but a big distributor. I believe he averages over 7 assists a game. So kind of what challenges does that present, and how are you guys planning on kind of getting good team defense on him?
I'm not sure yet how we'll match up, but usually, you know, we put Finn on other teams, like best guards or facilitators, and he does a really good job with that. I think helping him out, you know, being in our gaps, talking to him out there, and really guarding guys like that as a team will give us the best shot.
You guys are obviously kind of really battle-tested with this whole traveling. This is only be halfway across the country as opposed to traveling across the country and going to the Bahamas and everything. How do you feel like that early season stretch where you guys were constantly on the road has kind of prepared you for going into what's probably going to be pretty similar to a road environment playing in the Midwest against a team from the Midwest?
Right. I think earlier in the season, you know, in the moment, it kind of sucked. But, you know, now, like you said, it definitely prepared us. You know, we traveled the farthest, like, distance you could possibly go in the States. So I think now we're ready. You know, we're not going too far. We're kind of in some familiar territory with how close it is to some of the guys' homes. So I think we're ready for it, and it's a really good spot for us.
This program has obviously played a lot of close games against these power conference teams.
Yeah.
You guys are getting another shot at Marquette this coming, I guess it's Friday. How do you feel like you guys can, I don't know, maybe take the lessons that you learned from those games against those really good power conference teams? I know the Southern Cal team you played this year. And I don't know, just kind of impart that knowing kind of what you're up against.
Yeah, I think the biggest thing in these type of games is just not passing up good looks. Like, any open shots you can't pass up, because sometimes they don't come too often in games like these. So I think just going back and watching some of the tape from some of the other March Madness games will be big in that aspect and help us out. But just any look we get, I think, you know, we got to shoot and really capitalize on those opportunities.
How similar has this week been thus far compared to last year when you guys made
I think it's been kind of the same. You know, we've been enjoying the moment a lot, staying in it, you know, really happy for our journey and how we got it done. But I think we're a little more focused, and I think it's time to get one. And I think that's how everybody in the locker room, I think that's how all the coaches really feel. And we're just focused and prepared to go out there and get one done finally.
There hasn't been a lot of 15 seeds that have beaten twos the last couple of years. Or 15 seeds that not only won their first game but also won their second game. Does that give you any confidence?
Yeah, I think, you know, we got guys on this team that are scary, you know. Some of us make a three, we might not miss for the rest of the time, you know. So I think we're going to get hot, and we'll pull one out. I'm excited. Thank you.
Appreciate it.